does this reporter have in common with a car that won 3 races at Le Mans? A yacht that won the America's Cup? An unmanned air vehicle? And a uniform worn by Olympic speed skaters? They have all been tested at the University of Maryland's Glenn L. Martin Wind Tunnel. Dr. Jewel Barlow is one of the foremost wind tunnel researchers in the world and director of this unusual research lab on Maryland's College Park campus.
Almost anything that moves in air or water has found some occasion to be tested in this wind tunnel.
The wind tunnel was built in 1949 with a gift from aeronautics pioneer Glenn L. Martin. He wanted a place to test the aerodynamics of his new aircraft designs. In the 1950s and 60s, research focused mostly on testing aircraft. In the 70s and 80s, emphasis shifted to the automotive industry. The wind tunnel is self-supporting, earning its funding by doing research for outside clients. Many of these projects have earned international recognition for the university.
Before completing another lap, the checkered flag will be raised, and this punishing race will have been won for the third time running by a Ford car.
In the 1960s, wind tunnel researchers worked closely with Ford Motors to perfect the design for the GT40, a car which won the prestigious Le Mans road race 3 years in a row. In the mid-1980s, Ford returned to campus to conduct secret tests on a revolutionary new car design.
In the case of the Ford Taurus, it was the first car for mass sales whose design and shape was dominated by aerodynamics. We provided the sight and assistance in shaping that car.
Engineering students play key research roles in the Glenn L. Martin Wind Tunnel.
So I describe this building and the activities inside it as the most exciting and interesting place here at the University of Maryland.
Students commit to a year of full-time employment at the wind tunnel, working directly with paying clients. Graduate Shane Subin was recently hired by General Motors, one of the companies he assisted with aerodynamic testing.
Practical experience with real professionals. It's something that you can't learn in a classroom, and it's something that's absolutely invaluable and something that I never would have gotten anywhere else other than here.
Other high-profile projects at the wind tunnel include helping develop and test a new keel design for a yacht that won the America's Cup. Recently, researchers worked with Under Armour to test new designs for Olympic speed skating suits.
Speed skating is a really tough sport in the regards to aerodynamics because races are won and lost by 1/100 of a second or 1/1000 of a second. The competitive advantage that the U.S. has because of Under Armour and University of Maryland is unparalleled.
There's an incredibly diverse array of clientele that come through here, from automotive to aircraft and stuff that won't be seen by the public for another 2 to 3, sometimes 5 years.
As more and more new products and ideas are put to the test, the Glenn L. Martin Wind Tunnel at the University of Maryland remains a vital national center of innovative aerodynamic research.